Lucian vibes, the Caribbean tidal wave, repping our cultural waves and our Creole heritage. So much swag, my people, yeah, you know it feels like advantage.
Repping our rise and glide, yeah, I know you wanna see it. Come here, my girl, let me give you a little bikini. Dance and sing as everybody come along and help me sing this one.
Hello everyone, my name is Riali Gobo and I am here sitting in for my good friend Lep Shizzle. He asked me to host this episode for him because I am a professional dancer, well was, from way back when. So I used to do the dance, I used to do all type of that. So Lep Shizzle is my good friend, he asked me to host the dancer segment for him. Now, I'm going to be talking to you about different types of dances and Lep Shizzle, he himself spoke to different types of dancers in St. Lucia. But before we go into Lep Shizzle's interview, I want to show you this famous dance. It comes from Ghana, my home country Ghana. So the name of the dance is Azonto. I want you to learn it and go and do it with your friend and make your friend do it with their friend and their friend do it with their friend. So this song is called the Azonto. Just watch me do my Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now watch me do my Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now the good thing about the Azonto, you could mix it up anyhow you want. You could put any type of dancing in it. I am going to do it with my most favorite dance, which is called the Wheelie Box. Watch how I mix it up, and you will not even see it. Watch this. Wheelie Box. Wait, you see it? You did not see it. I will do it for you again, and you will see it. Wheelie Box. Wait, you see it, of course. All right, I will do. I will now mix it up with the Wacky Dance. Wacky, yes, that is right. I am a professional dancer from Ghana. My name is Riali Gobo. Before we go into the interview, I would like to show you another friend of mine. His name is Govan Javier, they call him Subat. And he is from the Mashi tribe in Ghana itself. And he did a very nice dance. I want to show you that dance. The dance is called the Godongo. Look at this boy do this dance. Very nice dance. Godongo, check it out.
This one is called the Godongo. For you to do the Godongo, you must go down low. You know it's jamming, DRC Mighty, Sandy, St. Justin. You call this the Godongo. What we do the Godongo, 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 Godongo,
is right. I tell you, the Godongo is a very nice dance. You have to go Godongo when you do this dance. Godongo. Let us go into the first interview with Lep Shizzle. Really go, boo. I am here in St. Lucia. That is right. Hold tight, don't trip me. Alright, Solution Vybz. Like Really Go Boog told you, today is all about the dancers. Straight dancing. And like he said, you know, he's a professional dancer from way back when. So we don't look for no trouble with him. Alright? Now, we're gonna kick off the show with a dance group from all the way down in Canaries. Now, I really wanted to go down there and, you know, get the whole Canaries feel, but I couldn't. So, we have one of the group's representatives with us. Her name is Jade Brown.
You forgot my name?
No, I was supposed to let you introduce yourself. But anyway, I was a little bit hasty there. But yeah, Jade is gonna be telling us about a great group from down in Canaries. What's the name of the group?
Twisted, of course. I'm sure everybody is familiar with the name by now. What do you want to know about Twisted? Because I have a lot to say.
All right. Well, I think where we got familiar with the name is from Jetty. Right, and also from Jetty we have Fundamentals. You're going to be seeing them a little later. So tell us about Twisted.
Okay. Twisted was formed by this young girl from Canaries. Her name is Delaney Lewis. I think she was about 16 at the time. There was only about 11 members. In 2009 it was formed, and it was with the vision to create something new, something innovative, something that would put Canaries on the map. And they started off with little kids, and then they progressed to, you know, the teenagers and the 20-something year olds. Myself and Delaney and Melisha were all contributing choreographers for Twisted. And basically, Twisted has taken part in so many activities since then. They have grown immensely, and it hasn't even been that long. And I know that the sky is the limit for Twisted. Like you said, they performed in Jetty, where you first heard of them. It was a learning curve. it was the first time that Twisted was in front of such a big audience, both on TV, you know, and on the stage, and it made them see their, realize their true potential. And although we didn't make it to the finals, we know that next year we are there. I mean, the only issues that we may have is with, you know, synchronization, but for the zeal, the effort, the energy, the creativity, Twisted has it, and we're deeply rooted in our community. Everything is about Canaries for us, and if you know anybody from Canaries, you know that we all have that sense of pride, that sense of community. Twisted has also performed at the Canaries Carnival events and several events, even Head Funk at the Salmon's Park, as we all know, we've been there. So, you know, the sky's the limit for Twisted, definitely.
Canaries massive! Pick up yourself. Now she said a mouthful, I have no more questions. Alright, one more question. What kind of dancing do they specialize in? Is it one type, or do they do across the board?
No, we do across the board, definitely, because we've received training since inception, but we specialize in Afro-Caribbean dance. So this is a bit of the African, the kizomba, the zouk, the compa, the then there's the bashman, the soca, the calypso, whatever it is that's Caribbean and that has that little tambo mele kind of feel, we can do it. We do it. That's us.
All right. I've known Jane for just a little about a year, and I didn't know she could dance. So in a while, she's going to give us a sample.
I don't think so.
Because I'm addicted to your loving, and to fight this feeling gets harder every day. I love your eyes, I love your smile, I love your skin. Your lips are irresistible, you're sexy, unforgettable. Oh boy, you have me, you have me on a high. You give me butterflies inside anytime you look into my eyes. I just can't get you out of my mind. You give me butterflies inside.
Oh, I just want to feel your love, baby, baby, oh yes.
That was something, oh my baby, oh my baby. That was it, oh my God, oh my God. We need to go to Fatima, oh my God, Fatima. That was something.
That is right, you are back with Reali Gobug. I am still here, I have not gone anywhere. I am still here with Lucian Vybz, and I am showing you the different type of dance. The next type of dancing we are going to check out, it is called salsa. I personally am not a big fan of salsa. I don't like salsa, I'm sorry. But it looked like my good friend Lep Shizzle, he likes salsa. He did some salsa. Let's see Lep Shizzle doing some salsa. You see, Lep Shizzle, he can do the salsa. He's alright, he's okay. Can do it better than him, but I don't like salsa. So let Lep Shizzle do the salsa. Let us go into the next interview, which Lep Shizzle conducted. Dancers segment, Lucian Vybz, Reali Gobug. Stop the camera, please. Alright, so Massive and Cool, we're still on the dancers segment. This episode is all about dancers, like I said. And today we're going to speak to a different type of dancing. What type of dancing do you do, sir?
We do a wide variation, like modern, contemporary, jazz, lyrical, folk, Afro jazz. It's quite broad with this group.
Now, what's your name, by the way?
I'm Jermaine Alexander.
Jermaine, I'm sure the face is familiar to a lot of the viewers. How long have you been doing this?
All my life, I should say. I started when I was 15. 15, yeah. Don't ask me my age.
Alright, so tell us about the name of your group and how far you've gotten in St. Lucia with the whole dancing vibe.
The name of the group is Miracle Dance Family. We started in 2001. We're still going strong. We're going so far. Most of our performances are at the hotel circuits and of course private functions and stuff like that. So this is what we mainly do. Of course we do a lot of charity as well, so you know, just living it up and just, you know, whatever comes around.
Right. So you've been around for a while. What do you think about dancing in St. Lucia? Do you think it's actually growing?
Yes, I should say so. I mean, for the last year, you can see, I mean, a lot of stuff starting to happen, especially with the Jazz and Arts Festival. They're creating avenues for dance now. So dancers don't have to struggle as much as before. At least there is something to look forward to come up, you know, at the every year, you know. But like I said, it's a growing thing. So hopefully we as dancers can create more stuff for ourselves, not just depending on the jazz.
What advice do you have to maybe the youngins coming up who maybe want to do their own thing? What advice you have for them in terms of getting into the whole dancing vibe?
Classes. Take as much classes, do as much workshop. Don't limit yourself to just breakdance, because there's so far it can take you. So you need to be able to do more than just breakdance. You need to be able to, I mean, especially in this time, in this world we're living in, you have to be able to do more. So if you challenge yourself and then you try to do a little hip hop, a little dub, a little soca, so you can use more, and then I guess your lifespan of dancing might, you know, be longer.
Right, and we know in St. Lucia, they tend to gravitate more to the contemporary soca type of dancing in terms of getting performances and whatnot, right?
Certain people ask you for exactly what they want. Certain venues call for exactly what they want. So, but you're supposed to keep to what you do. You keep to your craft, what makes you, so that you can stand out, so you can be different than everybody else. And of course, like I said, because you're going to be doing all this workshop, you should not just limit yourself into one bracket. Go to somebody else's classes, go around, see what they have to offer, see what your competition is, you know.
Yeah, sounds good. All right, so the Miracle Family, somebody's interested in dancing with Jumin and the Miracle Family. How did you go about it?
Well, they can look us up at, on Facebook, jiminalex@hotmail.com, and you can get me here, and you can just come to the St. Joseph Convent. We're here from Monday to Thursday from 5:30 to 7 o'clock.
Yeah. I'd also like to make mention of Jumin's dance partner, which have impressed me over and over again. What's her name, by the way?
Bianca Alexander.
Yes. And I'm sure you've seen them around carrying all over the place and like some wrong kind of thing. Alright, so the Miracle Dance Family, let's see what Miracle Dance Family can do. This is one of their classes. Check it out.
Reality Go Book here again on Lucian Vybz in the dancers segment. Now, before we go into the interview again, this is all about dancing, I tell you, and we are right here in St. Lucia doing the dancing. Look here, this type of dance, it is called the Lucian
Boy Wine. You have never seen this type of dancing before. Yes, you have, because it's right here in St. Lucia. You just didn't know the name. Let us go to Radio Out and Bad, and they will show you the dance. Lucian Boy Wine, look at it.
Shake your left twash.
Yeah.
Then your right twash.
All right.
Shake your left twash.
Yeah.
Then your right twash.
Yeah.
Now shake, jiggle it, jiggle it, jiggle it. Hold on.
That is what I tell you, the Lucian Boy Wine, you know how to do it. It has been here all the time. Now I will also show you the Lucian Girl Wine. Yeah, I like to see that one, the Lucian Girl Wine. You see it, right? You know how to do it. It is the Lucian Girl Wine. You girls do it every day. Boys do the Lucian Boy Wine. I see y'all. Let us go into the last interview that Lep Sizzle conducted on the dancers segment of Lucian Vibes. That is right.
Alright, so Lucian Vibes. Today is ancillary vibes. And it's not just ancillary vibes. It's dancing vibes. Right?
Right.
Yeah. We're in the community of ancillary. A little fishing village of ancillary. And there are one bad dance group inside ancillary. I do come down here. I do come down and look for them. To show you all them. Hopefully you all saw them already. I'm not going to tell you your name. I'll let them tell you your name. What's your name?
My name is Nilka Gonzaga.
Okay, Nilka, what's the name of the dance group?
Fundamentals.
Fundamental. It's very fundamental, and we speak to fundamentals right about now. Tell us, how long have you guys been dancing?
Yes, as a group from October, so that's like a few months.
Yeah, my name is Jobert Wilson, also known as Shewis. Most of y'all know me as that name, yes.
Shewis.
Yes, Shewis.
That name just sounding bad. Alright, so talk to us about the group from since October. How far have y'all gone? Talk to us about the gigs y'all have gotten.
We haven't gotten much gigs, but we're still rehearsing, expecting big from the Jetty people and was not the organization, but people from Anstery have given us chances to perform. Like, they had an outreach thing on Friday, asked us to perform, we did well. A music lounge from Youth on Fire Ministry, we performed there as well. So we're just doing little things for the time, but we'll get there.
All right, so I guess in the name Fundamentals got big through Jetty. What do you really think about the whole Jetty vibe?
That was a very good gesture, I must say, because it brought kind of unity towards us and thing, because we were individual dancers. We're not Brandon Dexter and Emmanuel. We used to perform in another group, but the other person, Dexter Moglo, he was an individual on his own, a breakdancer, used to do his own thing and what's not. And we used to watch him, but never quite saw what he had until he came together with us. And, you know, as a breakdancer, moving from just floor moves and all that and start doing choreography, yeah.
What kind of dancing the group specialize in? Is it one type of dancing?
Nah, not one, all types, but mainly, what will I say, hip-hop, but we love African as well. Really love African, but mainly hip hop.
Yeah, man, that is a real dance group.
Yeah.
Too sick in the place.
Yeah.
Alright, so tell us about your experience with Jetty, and from October to now as a dancer. What can you talk us about the experience?
It was a big one, you know. I feel like, what? Like, that was just amazing. You know, I never pictured myself taking part in that Jetty competition, you know. It so happened that when Shewis asked me to join the group, I was like, you really want me to join the thing? Like, me, of all persons, me? You know, I had that kind of little shyness inside of me, you know, that part that said, not to do it, Nilka, but then the other part was like, it doesn't kill to try something new. And I joined the Jetty competition, the competition thingy, and I stayed with Fundamentals all the way. I gave it my all, I did what I had to do. Even though I wasn't good at one, two dances, for instance, the contemporary, I tried, and that was just amazing. So that Jetty thing brought exposure and confidence in me as a person.
You had a loose, all natural.
Yes.
She said shy. Guys, you're not
I was
shy. You said, you know, shy. What's that?
Well,
bad boy.
Brandon Gonzaga.
Alright, I think I remember you were doing a couple of tricks on that.
Yeah.
Talk to us about the experience from October to now. You started dancing in October or you've been dancing before?
I've been dancing before.
And talk to us about the experience in the whole dancing vibe for you, where you have, where you've been, where you are now.
Well, I started dancing from Form 1, and then I started working on different things, new things, but my main type of dancing I loved was breakdancing. And now I got exposed to, you know, different types of dance, and yeah, it has been great. It's getting greater for me, better for all of us, and it has just been something I love. Yeah, and that's, dancing is the only thing I love right now. Yeah,
except for the girl. Anyway, you mentioned that y'all are not really getting gigs and whatnot. But if it continues down that path, what do you think will happen? Do you think the group will break up, or do you think y'all will continue?
No, we'll continue. Well, for me, we'll continue, and I'm hoping they feel the same way. Yeah, it will. That will not stop us.
Love doing.
That's our passion, dancing.
Good vibe, good vibe. Now, my little advice to you all, I mean, there's not really a big avenue for dancers in St. Lucia, but I always believe, as a person, as an individual, you could always make things happen. You know, in terms of things like music videos, you check?
Yeah.
You always have dancers. Myself looking for dancers, so I might end up coming back down here anytime soon. Alright? Now, you know we can't live lost that way if fundamentals give us a little sample. But before we do that, there's only 3 people in the group, no?
No, 5.
What's the first name?
Emmanuel and Dexter.
That's the 2 that I'm missing.
Yeah.
Right, big up Emmanuel and Dexter, wherever you are. You'll miss my interview. Avex, we done slurry.
Personally, I rock your body. I promise you go home, you won't tell daddy. I gave it to you like you never had it. Screaming, judging, chill, like speaking Chinese. Now waiting me this, back a boom boom. Now waiting I see, Zaga, cause she know I'm me. She talks so she know I'm me.
I know go lie, the things within my mind. When I see you dancing, girl, you got me high. And if you wanna try, make a good day tonight. I'm in the mood, as long as you're feeling the good, I deal with you.
Personally,
I go deal with you.
Make it dip, make it rock so. Let me see how your body go. Make it dip, make it rock so. Let me see how your body go. Make it dip, make it rock so. Let me see how your body go. Make it dip, make it rock so.
Right. And this is Reali Gobug here again. And again, I have been hosting the Lucian Vybz show this time around. Why? Because I am a professional dancer from way back when. I did all type of dances, all the dances you see today. I did them from way back when. Now this has been the Lucian Vybz show. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I thank you for watching me, Reali Gobug, on the Lucian Vybz show. I say, stay tuned. Check us right back here next time for another episode of the Lucian Vybz show. That is right. With your boy Lep Chisel and his friends Amanda. Oh, Amanda, yes. And Finesse. Oh, Finesse, yes. Join us right back here next time for another episode of Lucian Vybz. Thank you for watching. I am out of here. I am gone. Goodbye. I will see you another time. Reali Gobug. I will see you again. Bye-bye. You not go. You no go. You don't want me to go. I can stay. If you want me to stay, you want me to go. All right, I will go. Should I end this here? You don't go. You want me to go? No. Okay, I will go.
Professor, who say a mongrel? Let me unplug for the option. Flavor for your food, what you put in cell? How you calling ladder in Creole?